All right, let's get back into the bonus from the dating experience. This would be the official extended, okay? So we found out some surprising things from your last video. We saw that you're adjusting to a new person, re-entering the dating experience or the dating game. Some of you are open to meeting someone quite like you, or they have the same type of schedule. I sense a coworker too. Some of you through mutual friends is what we picked up in the previous video. Also, somebody that can be introduced to you through a public engagement or again through friends. So we look at the High Priestess. It's a major arcana from that video. So it's Pisces. And in a pointed read, the best thing that you can do is look at the major arcana that show up, okay? Some of the minors in your last video were the Ten of Pentacles. So it's a longevity-based card. It's also about family. Some of you who are in your 30s, okay, or your early 40s, you're looking for that relationship that's going to stand the test of time. We are in a soulmate type of era, and Libras are the ones who like to be in love. So let's take it from that point. I'm going to do a three-card split here on my table. Excuse me, and I just messed it up. So I'm going to try that again. Some of them are reversed, but I'm going to take them upright for this particular reading. So there's one, two, and three. I'm also going to shuffle my deck here. Welcome back to your extended. So we look at the High Priestess. Can I check out what that energy means so I could read it for my viewers here? And welcome to the morning one. It's very different. So I just wanted to ask you to open your thoughts today. Even if you disagree with some of the points that are brought up in this video, that's fine. That's why it's being done, because you get to chime back in today's comment section. I'm leaving it open so I can see also what placement you are in. And we're also going to check on Libra side in just a second. What is the High Priestess here? It's still on the table. Let's see that Pisces energy toward a new person. How are we feeling as Libras? We have the Eight of Swords. We have some fears attached to, that's coming out as like fears to go back into the dating world. Even making a profile might make you nervous, or it's not really your thing. So we do have the Eight of Swords. Can I match that card, please? Thank you so much. New topic for today, huh? We have the Seven of Pentacles, but you're willing. There's fears involved, but we're willing. What that tells me is that you have to, it's almost like it's time. It's time to break free from the norm of our everyday. Okay, it's like Groundhog Day when this happens. You're very willing for the investment. That's a good spot, Libras, for the Seven of Pentacles. Again, in the first video, it talked about a readiness to open up to people. I do feel like the Three of Cups is something that you already do. There is a type of Libran atmosphere when you are very talkative, because you talk about your interests, you speak about the things that you're passionate about. Let's say spirituality is exactly that, it's your passion. You're ready to talk about those things because you've built up knowledge to do so. The Seven of Pentacles can traversely be read as well as somebody who wants to interact with you, and they see you as the Seven of Pentacles. Remember, we reverse energies too, if that's not us. So they are willing as well. What's in the heart space of Libra to get ready to do this? The Knight of Pentacles. It's been slow. It's been a long journey to get back here. What I pick up, because I can see specific energy, the Knight of Pentacles is a long time of being single too. It's been a journey of being alone. And we have this horse. Again, we have horses a lot in our reads lately. It's patience, it's guidance to lead you to the right person. I do think a lot of you will be surprised it will come from close quarters. So this means people that you already know. I do sense a lot of coworkers that are trying to find or match you with somebody, or it's a sibling even. So if you do have these older brothers or sisters, or you have relationships that are very close in ties with you, I want to mention that they're willing to work with you too. They want to see that you have an investment that you work through as well. It can be societal here, like some people are just pushing you to get back out there, but they are your best cheerleaders, okay? So I don't see anybody here trying to press that upon you. Let's see what else you have in the heart space. I want to get a couple more cards. We have Judgment. That's reconciliation sometimes for me as a reader, and I got nails today, so Judgment. I believe that was in like a couple days ago readings too, if it wasn't yesterday itself in the Twin Flame. In some aspects, it can be reconciliation, and I'll tell you why. A judgment call can be whatever you decide. We have the gift of free will. So if you decide to go back to a past person, that can also be what you're energetically putting out there. It doesn't have to be, though. It can just be you're deciding to get back into things. Put yourself out there. We do have the Four of Swords, the Knight of Cups, and a King of Cups. In dating, I do see that romance will be brought to you. I really don't think that you have to do a lot, Libra. Right now, as Aquarius is an air sign and Pluto is interacting in Aquarius, it seems like the air sign people will do better in this area. Communication, discipline, King and Queen of Swords is the type of thing that you'll see going into this transit. There's a lot of interactions with good people that you can have, and they're also coming from similar storylines. They've been heartbroken in the past. They've seen recent Three of Swords. So I do sense like a crying on your shoulder as well. Somebody might be overtelling or overspeaking on a story that they've already spoken about many, many times over, but it's going to be slow coming toward you because we do have a Knight of Pentacles in terms of speed, okay? Is there going to be compassion for you? Yes, I already see that in the card play. King of Cups is somebody who will try to open up about their stories. They could be a Scorpio, a new one coming in. If you dealt with a past Scorpion or Scorpio person, they could be coming back around. I also have the cards for that. They could be coming around to speak to you. This could be confirmation. If some of you dealt with a water sign, this person can also try to reconcile with you during this time. But you're wanting to feel something new, all right? My cue cards for that is the Knight of Cups and also Judgment traversely. So let's see what else is going on here with the activity space, okay? What are the mutual cards in this story? Five of Swords. I knew I was going to see that. Five of Swords could be stories from both sides. You're going to speak with what you come from. Some of you will speak on a path from divorce or a connection to somebody. You're going to detail maybe a little bit here about that struggle. You're going to be willing to share. They are also going to return that with their Five of Swords. The mutual cards are a Page of Wands. Again, I get this feeling like it's been a long time coming. Okay, both of you are ready for this. Again, it displays a page. We have a page attitude towards the dating experience. They do see that you have a level of adventure to you, either from the past or you currently live with this type of adventure. Some of you could be working on your physical fitness. The Page of Wands sometimes to me can be someone who's very physically active. You do take care of yourself. So the Page of Wands is exactly that. It's coming in with fresh new excitement, back in the game after a long time sort of thing. And I think that you're ready to do that. Okay, so if you're opening up to it, whether it be online, you're ready to introduce yourself to people. Again, it's like something through work, and I'm going to keep saying it because it looks like it's something from a place where you're seen often. Six of Cups, Ace of Cups, and the Star. Nice cards for the conclusion. The basis here is like an emotional awareness that you have to get this over with. It's the beginning of a new chapter. This is a beginnings card, the Ace of Cups. It also speaks there. If you see, she's presenting it from the center of her chest in an honest fashion. Some of my females on the channel, if you're a divine feminine, you're going to begin to share parts of your story, even the struggle points, okay? Again, I would advise not oversharing because it might deter people from really getting to know you and spending time with you. I would say do it in small increments. It's showing up in the cards because they already view you as somebody that's ready for a new chapter. Okay, so all the heavy details, I would keep at bay in the very beginning just to get to know each other and the basis of talking. Six of Cups is here too. And I want to say that there is a remembrance of somebody keenly from the past. It could have ended bad too. I'm not saying here it's a perfect story. Nobody comes from a perfect story. So the Six of Cups, and I'm just going to hand shuffle while I tell you, hear what I see. You are both seen from a new person and an old as the Queen of Pentacles. I have her here presently on the desk today. It means that this Capricorn energy is still very much seen by other people. For me today, it's an environmental card in your dating experience video. There is a past person that keeps coming back, and I am going to read the cards the way that they come out. Many people don't like past inferences, but I read my cards. And so what I have to tell you is that the Six of Cups is an honest measure from someone who still views you as an ideal mate, okay? Ideal partner, you still got it, is what I'm kind of feeling here. The energy is you still got it, okay? So in this seated position, again, you see that this person is still relaxed, calm, and tranquil, very tranquil. You've been left in this position for too long. So as we move forward, lots of offers coming from this particular energy. This is the card today for that. Knight of Cups. Okay, what's crossing her is this Ace of Cups. It's like this on my desk. So coming in with a cup of love, there's a readiness again that I feel from the Queen of Pentacles. Because we have healed. We have a huge card to say that you're a healed one. Some of you will test out your gifts. I'm also sensing that in this video. During this experience, you're going to test out your intuitive gifts, maybe even hear extra tapped in before you meet a certain individual. That might already be happening in your daily life. So that's really interesting to see here too. I didn't think I was actually going to see it on the table today, and it comes out. We have a Queen of Swords. Okay, Four of Pentacles, the Strength card, Five of Swords, and the Six of Cups again. All right, Justice is at the bottom of the deck. Justice is here. All of your important Libra energies are showing up. I just want to tell you, Queen of Swords twice, the Star, I consider you as on the channel, and the Justice card. The beautiful element here is most of them are major arcana, which means there's a shift going on specifically in this story because it's a pointed read. If we were to just touch on the Six of Cups, let's go there. If this is a past relationship, they do feel rocked by your presence being gone, okay? They could be physically reminded of notes from the past is what I'm picking up here. Notes and hints of your possibility. They look at what was lost in a way where I see these blue flowers, and I'm going to explain it to you as an intuit. The blue flowers are little peaks and reminders of the best moments they experienced with you. Okay, one more time, the best moments they had experienced. And I'll tell you why I was drawn there physically as a reader. Justice is dressed in actually this beautiful blue dress. These are hints of you to the Six of Cups person. Okay. Hints and little references. This is a beautiful Justice card because it's very simple. I just want to show you guys. She's just here delegating what's about to happen, whether it's a courtroom, whether something's happened in this medieval deck, right? And the jurisdiction has been laid out. So the new chapter seems very apparent here in your reading. Are you adjusting? Sure, to a new person. The Knight of Cups is at the bottom of the deck after multiple shuffles. Star again, the Eight of Cups, and the Queen of Pentacles. I'm going to show you that it keeps going back to this court card. New dating looks like it will be inviting for you. Some of it is like majestic because I think you're going to have a good time, a lot of laughter. But I also see here that a Five of Swords is a constant reminder. This is a card that keeps spilling out, by the way. So the Five of Swords is a reminder of somebody that you dearly experience things with. And as adults, we cannot erase those memories. We still feel very keen towards them. We still have a place in our heart for this person, no matter how bad it ended. For some of you, that's part of the story this person is interested in, the new Knight of Cups here. And they all see from every point and angle that you're the Queen of Pentacles. Libras are very, very good here. And they keep this spot quite well because of that balance that constantly has to be had, both emotionally and physically. I want to end the reading there with the Queen of Pentacles. Let's see what's coming in for her in terms of a gift, okay? Many of you are gifted empathic ones. I want to thank you for joining me for this beautiful reading. I think we might have to do more of these in the future. Maybe adjust to these type of readings too. So let's see here, Queen of Pentacles, what's coming in for her? A lot of cards, please. Another blue-dressed individual, the High Priestess. Your gifts will be increased. You could already be practicing that on some level. What I do at some points is I journalize feelings, and that could really help you get into your high priestess if you're not there. Okay, so if some days you're not feeling tapped in, you're not surveying your environment that great, I feel like journaling can help you. Another blue-dressed individual in there. A lot of synchronicities today. The Queen of Pentacles will be receiving the Hierophant, okay? Very in touch with spirituality or connecting to your guides, connecting to things from the ethers that help you. I will say even here, guidance videos, that can make you feel ultra spiritual. When you watch people delegate cards or they shuffle, it might be calming for you. So we see here that you have a connection to what's in the heart space. We do have Taurus here, so there could be an incoming Tauran advisor, or maybe like a friend, a Tauran friend, or you could even be dating a Taurus coming up. That is a good match because it is the Empress energy. Libra and Taurus both rule that, or rule Venus. So that's a good match overall. Seven of Cups, that is the last card. You get a lot of options in February. That's one way to read it. Your options become clear to you. They could be physically approaching you too at this current time, or you have other options here in life choices, like a lot of job opportunity, time to stretch your legs, things like that, into the new open space, which is this transit. So the Queen of Pentacles looks like she's working with others at this time. I do see like some challenge, and I'll list it to you, the Ten of Wands from the previous reading, temperance, that could even be a challenge with your own patience, but you're looking at it in terms of your own necessity at this time. There is harmonious energy with this Knight of Cups, okay? I do want to mention that they could be the best of the bunch, maybe a more prime opportunity to seek out some of their advice. They could be really talkative in the future. Just to slow it down here a little bit too, it could be a mutual friend. I see that in the Knight of Cups being brought to you by other outside people. You know, these other cups can be friends too. So I see that they kind of pop out and protrude to you from that grouping. Okay, let me know if this is a proper bonus in the future, Libras. I would love to continue to do the dating experience types of videos for you. Let me know what resonated for you personally today. Even if it's just a couple sentences, I like to hear back from you guys during these little podcasts and topic discussions. Thank you for your time as always, and take care for today.